स्टूडेंट्स, आप क्लास 12 आरएस इंटर कॉलेज कानपुर। टुडे आई वांट टू इन्फॉर्म यू दैट योर फर्स्ट टर्म एग्जामिनेशन विल बी हेल्ड ऑन 18th, 19th एंड 20th ऑफ मे। सो यू शुड कंप्लीट द कोर्स एंड यू शुड स्टार्ट टू लर्न आल्सो। The multiple choices questions will be asked. The test paper will be 35 marks and very short questions will be asked. From grammar portions, the short questions, fill in the blanks type, like fill up the prepositions, etc., will be asked and you have to prepare it. And attend the class daily so that you may bring the good marks, satisfactory marks, and they will also be helpful in your board examination. So it is your duty to attend the class daily and to listen the video, to learn the question answers, read the book, textbook of English, and then you may be successful surely. The marks should be good, you have to remember it. As again I am repeating, the lesson second from Flamingo or Prose, the name of the lesson is Lost Spring, written by Anish Jung. So in this lesson I explained to you that the writer has written against the child labor, the child exploitation. The poor children have to dirty work in the dhabas, hotels, in the houses of the rich people. They had to work like the washing of the cup plates, wiping and sweeping the house, and also many of them do the work of rag pickers. Rag pickers means something selecting from the piles of the garbage, rubbish heaps. And after picking the gold, that has been called gold to them, to the poor people. Whatever they pick up from the garbage piles or heaps, and they sell them to earn their living, to earn their bread. Those things are called here in this lesson gold, not for gold matter. So, because these things are gold for them, so the something valuable thing that is selected by the poor children from the piles of the garbage or rubbish is called gold. In this way, I told you yesterday there was a very attractive boy, Sahib Alam. The meaning of Sahib Alam is Lord of Universe, means God. Such majestic title and such a poor, helpless luck. What a pitiful condition of the boy is, that without slippers or shoes he wanders from one place to other place, from one street to other street, from one pile of the garbage to other piles, and he is searching something which may be valuable for him. Writer one day asked Sahib Alam if he wanted to go to school. The boy replied that there is no school for the poor children. The writer asked if she made the school for the poor children, would he come? he agreed to go to the school, but it is pitiable that school was not constructed. And the second boy was Mukesh. He was working in the glowing glass factories or industries. Not only he, but his parents also worked in the bangle industries, where bangles for the women are made in Firozabad. Firozabad is famous for bangles and bracelets made of glass. So there is the high temper glowing glass furnaces where the children have to work. About 20,000 children are working in Firozabad. So this is the child labor. This is the exploitation of the children. So this voice should be arisen so that there may be ban against the child exploitation, the child labor, so that the children may go to the school and study. They may get education. They may brighten their future. So it is not only the duty of the government, but it is also the duty of the social members, social reformers. They should also make efforts to improve the bad luck of the poor children. Although Mukesh is working in the bangle industry, but he makes a plan to work in a garage so that he may be motor mechanic, car mechanic, he may repair the car, and after some time he may learn to drive the car. So in this way he wants to escape from the conspiration, from the trap of the moneylenders, policemen, politicians, leaders, industrialists, etc. He is firmly determined to go to the garage, to learn the work of repairing the motors, and wants to learn how to drive a car. So this is his iron will, and God may help him. Not only Mukesh, but also 20,000 children are working in the glowing glass furnaces in Firozabad. So the writer wants that the government should pay attention towards this problem. The social reformers also should pay their attentions to pay their attention towards the exploitation of the children in the industries, in the domestic works, and in other offices where the children are exploited and they are not given the facility for the getting education. So they should be also helped in this direction so that their future may be brightened and they may also prosper. They may also enjoy the life of the middle class people and also may enjoy the comfortable.